Welcome to Power Apps and Dataverse for Teams. Today, we're going to build our very first app in Power Apps. And we'll do so in three easy steps. Create the app, create a table, and then we'll wire it all up and let the magic happen. We'll integrate it right there where all the work is happening in Microsoft Teams. So let's get started. Now, one thing that I always like to do is popping out the Power Apps app from Microsoft Teams. Can do so by right-clicking the icon and choosing Pop Out. This ensures that I can attend to my day-to-day job, respond to chats, attend meetings, or even collaborate on documents in Microsoft Teams without ever having to lose context or progress in the Power Apps app. We are now ready to take our first step, and that's creating the app. By simply clicking the Create an App button, I get a chance to choose a team. This is where my app will be stored, and this is also the place where I can share my app with the other members as soon as I decide that I'm ready for it. So I'll simply go ahead and choose a team, and then click Create. If this is the first time creating an app in a specific team, you'll notice it takes a bit of time. That's because we're setting up a Dataverse for Teams environment for this team. That only needs to happen once, but it gives you a powerful relational database engine that you can leverage to build your apps. Of course, if you already have data in some other place, you can leverage one of our 300 plus connectors to get that data in your app. As soon as the environment is created, we're redirected to the studio. The only thing we need to do here is provide a name and save. We are now ready for step two, creating the table. Simply click Create a Table and then provide a name. I'm going to choose Product because I'm creating a product browser. Notice that under Advanced Setting, it already provided me a plural name, but I can of course control it. Upon saving, I will now be able to add the columns to my table. Now, aside from the name, which I'm getting by default, I also want the price. Notice there's multiple types I can choose from. I choose decimal. And again, I have advanced controls to configure exactly what I need. Next, I'm going for a category, which is going to be a choice field. This is a list of predefined options. When I'm done with the predefined options, I'm going to go to create my next column, which is trending. I want a yes/no field to define if a certain product is trending this month or not. Finally, I'll add two more, a description field that describes my product, a simple text field, and I can change the length of the text field. And finally, there's an image so that I can visualize the product that we're talking about. With all the columns created, I can now add the data. And this is like working Excel. I can manually type in all the values. I can copy paste from Excel. Or there's actually also an option to edit the data directly from Excel connected to this table. In this case, I just copied the right values in, and I'm ready to go to the next step. Notice how the data is immediately wired up to my app. I can click on Preview here on the top right to preview my app as it is. It's already working. On the left side, I have a list, a gallery of all my products. And on the right side, I see the details for each product. Now, in this preview, I can also resize the window and preview how it will behave on different screen sizes. Notice how it's responsive to the size. If we're happy with the app how it is, we're actually ready to publish it and make it available to others. But I'm going to do an extra step first. I'm going to customize it a little bit to my own liking. So the first thing I'm going to do is exit the preview. We're going to start by customizing the gallery. Simply by left-clicking the gallery, anywhere but on the first item. And then on the right side in the properties window, I'll change the layout. It comes with a series of predefined layouts, which I can of course customize to my own needs. But I'm going for a predefined one. I'll change the wrap count from 2 to 1. I just want one item per row. And then I can also change the template size. It's currently an expression that calculates the minimum between 320 or the height of its container. I'm gonna change that minimum to 160. As a next step, I'll also change the fields which are used. Notice that we now have the name of the product and the price. Well, I want to have the category there instead. Have you noticed how every change you made is immediately visible in the designer? There's no explicit save or run or compile step. It's just there. It's just working. This makes us extra productive when we're building apps. Okay, let's do a few more changes. I would like that this gray banner in the gallery with the image would actually change color when a product is trending or not. That visualizes that value for all my users. I start by selecting the banner in the first item of the gallery. And then I can go to the color property. I can choose the color from the predefined ones. Or I can click on the color label here. And that will set the expression bar on the top to the right property. And I can now use that to write an expression. Just like in Excel, I can use a formula. I'm going to use, in this case, a formula which is going to look at the value of the trending in the table. So I go this item, which is referring to the selected item that we're looking at, getting the trending value, dot trending, and then I go for a color dot orange red if trending is true, or dark gray if trending is false. And immediately we see it in the outcome. I'm pretty happy with the gallery now. So I'm going to do a few more changes on the form on the right side, and that will finish it. So let's click anywhere on that form, and I can change properties like I did on the gallery before. In this case, the columns from 3 to 2, and with the fields property, I can control which columns are added to the form. So I can, for example, remove the image as I don't want it here. With that all done, we've completed our 3 steps. We created an app, we created a table, and then we customized the app to our needs. Now we're just gonna publish it so others can start using it. Click on Publish to Teams, click on Next, and then I can choose where I want to have the app in my team. So I can add it to one of my channels here, and click Save and Close. Let's go and see what it looks like in Teams. Isn't that amazing? We just built our first app in Teams. Every team member can now use it wherever they are, on the web, in desktop, or on mobile. Now remember, this is just the first step. There's so much more you can do. You can add multiple screens. You can use those expressions to filter on data. You can build complex controls and much, much more. I am so glad I'm part of your journey, and I'm hoping to see you again soon as one of our Power Apps champions.